गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन. सो नाइन क्लास, हाउ आर यू ऑल? क्लास, हैव यू एंजॉयड माई प्रीवियस चैप्टर? वाई डू वी फॉल इल? नाउ क्लास, आई हैव कम्प्लीटेड फाइव डू वी फॉल इल चैप्टर. नाउ आई विल स्टार्ट माई सेकेंड बायोलॉजी चैप्टर क्लास, द फंडामेंटल यूनिट ऑफ लाइफ. इट्स क्लास चैप्टर नंबर 5, द फंडामेंटल यूनिट ऑफ लाइफ. राइट, let's start from here. While examining a thin slice of cork, Robert Hooke saw that cork resembled the structure of a honeycomb, consisting of many little compartments. Cork is a substance which comes from the bark of a tree, and this was in the year 1665 when Hooke made this chance observation through a self-designed microscope. Robert Hooke called these boxes cells, and cell is a Latin word for a little room. This may seem to be a very small and insignificant incident, but it's very important in the history of science. This was the very first time that someone had observed that living things appear to consist of separate units. The use of the word cell to describe these units is being used till this day in biology. Right? So class, here I will tell you here one thing. Robert Hooke, right? The only man we have here, Robert Hooke. Class, class, Robert Hooke has observed cork, right? Cork is a substance which is obtained from the bark of a tree. From this paragraph, what we conclude? Cork is a substance which is obtained from the bark of a tree. And Robert Hooke's discovery was very important. Why? Because it indicated for the first time that living organism consisted of a number of smaller structure, right? Or we can say unit. So class, in the year 1665, Hooke made this chance discovery, right, via microscope. So we can say discovery of cell is by Robert Hooke. Why? Because first time Robert Hooke has discovered this thing. We are talking about here cell. So Robert Hooke is an English scientist, right? In 1665 he discovered and named the cells. While examining a thin slice of bottle cork, right, Hooke observed cork honey, or we can say porous structure, right? Hooke found porous structure of cork to resemble with monasteries and called the unit cell. Let's talk about here. What are living organisms made up of? This is an activity. Don't go for the activity. I will discuss this later. So we have here, what do we observe as we look through the lens, right? This is glass microscope structure. You can see compound microscope. Upper part we have eyepiece, and base you can see we have here mirror also, right? What do we observe as we look through the lens? Can we draw the structure that we are able to see through the microscope, right? On an observation seat, does it look like this? Yes, class. When we place a onion peel under microscope, so this structure will come out, right? This you can see cells of an onion peel, right? In this structure, you can see we have cells and a center black point. Class, that is nucleus. So class, let's talk about here next page. as we have here, we can try preparing temporary mounds of peel of onions of different size. What do we observe? And do we similar structure or different structure? Let's talk about what are these structures, what we have seen, right, under the microscope class. These structures look similar to each other. Together they form a big structure like an onion bulb. We find from this activity that onion bulbs of different size have similar structure which is visible under a microscope, right? And the cells of the onion peel will all look the same regardless of the size of the onion they came from. These small structures that we see are the basic building units of the onion bulb. It means we can say small structures we can see under the microscope are what? These are the building units of onion bulb. And these structure class called cells. Not only onions, even all the organisms we observe around are made up of cells. Even every human being, or we can say all organisms which we have on the planet of Earth, all are made up of cells. However, there are also single cells that live on their own. The invention of magnifying lens led to the discovery of the microscopic world. It is now known that a single cell may constitute a whole organism, as in amoeba class. Single cell organism are amoeba. Example of single cell organism is amoeba. Now moving towards the right side paragraph. Chlamydomonas, paramecium, bacteria class. All these organisms are unicellular organism. Uni means single. Single cellular organism. On the other hand, many cells group together in a single body and assume different functions in it to form various body parts in a multicellular organisms. Multi means many. It means we are talking about here many cell organism which perform different function for our body, such as fungi, plants and animals. Can we find out names of some more unicellular organism? Yes, try to find out. Now we have next paragraph here. Every multicellular organism has come from a single cell. But how? Cells divide to produce cells of their own kind. All cells thus come from pre-existing cells. As you class know, every new organism come from the pre-existing organism, right? It means those cells which are new, which are producing, they come from the pre-existing cells. So some organism can also have cells of different kinds. Look at these following picture. It depicts some cells from the human body. As you can see class, this class, this yellowish part you can see, it is a nerve cell, and this black dot is a blood cell, and this vertical is smooth muscle cell, and we have here ovum, and this is class bone cell, and this you can see this is sperm, and this right side we have fat cell. So class, these all are various cell from our human body. In human body, these cell generally we can see, right? We cannot see any cell without microscope. So class, if I will talk about here cell, I can say all cells, right? whether they exist as one-celled organism, right? One-celled means class unicellular, unicellular, right? Unicellular organisms or a part of a multicellular organism, both of them are capable of carrying certain basic functions such as nutrition, respiration, growth and reproduction. Either it is unicellular or multicellular, both are capable for basic function, right, class, such as nutrition, respiration, growth and reproduction. Do one thing, just take one notebook and pen and write some points in your notebook, class. Write down unicellular organism. From this page, we conclude some data that you have to write in your note. Write down first topic, unicellular organism. Right, class? First write down, uni means single. Uni means single, right? Write down about unicellular, class. Unicellular organism represented by single cell, represented by single cell, and reproduction consumes a single cell. All activities of the organisms are performed by a single cell. Either it is respiration, reproduction, nutrition, all will be performed by single cell. Now write down multicellular organism. Multi means many. Multi means many. And multicellular organism consists of large number of cells, and a single cell perform one or few activities of the organism. In class, only some cell of the body is called germ cell, which take part in reproduction, right? So, and we have some specialized part which perform different functions of our body, right? So this is actually a division of labor within the cells. So you have to write only multicellular organism in which you have to mention it consists of large number of cells. Now class, let's move towards our next topic. On next page, yes, third page, we have first paragraph. The shape and size of cells are related to the specific function they perform. Some cells like amoeba have changing shape, right? Amoeba, we can see amoeba generally change its shape, right? In some cases, the cell shape could be more or less fixed and particular. For a particular type of cell, for example, nerve cells have a typical shape. Nerve cell have a typical shape. Now let's talk about here, class. Next paragraph. Each living cell has the capacity to perform certain basic function. Each living cell, it means single cell has the capacity to perform basic function. Basic function are nutrition, respiration, right? These are basic function, class. So how does a living cell perform these basic function? This thing will come in your mind, right? We know that there is a division of labor in multicellular organisms such as human beings, This means the different parts of the human body perform different functions. In our body class, there are specialized organs which are designed to perform different functions, right? Like we have human digestive system, right? So the function of human digestive system is different. Each and every part of human digestive system work differently, right? So it means we can say different parts of the human body perform different functions. The human body has a heart which pump blood. Which pump blood. And a stomach, it digests food and so on. Similarly, division of labor is also seen within a single cell. It's not like only division will be in multicellular organism class, it will be also happen in single unicellular organism. In fact, each cell has got certain specific components within it known as cell organelles. Each kind of cell organelle performs a special function, such as making new material in the cell, clearing up the waste material from the cell, and so on. It means class, we have some kind of a cell organelle in our body and which have different special function for them, like to excrete waste material, right? A cell is able to live and perform all its functions because of these organelles, right? These organelles together constitute the basic unit, which is called cell. It is interesting that all cells are found to have the same organelles, no matter what their function is or what organism they are found in. Right, class? So, in short, we can say we have here different function of some special organelle, right, which perform different activity in our body, right? So I will mention here one more point, class. If you remember, cytoplasm, DNA, RNA, right? I will discuss class in deeply in my next topic, all these points, right? So here we have, what is a cell made up of and what is the structural organization of a cell? Class, as you can see in first paragraph of it, we saw above that cell has special components which is called organelles, right? As I told you, I will discuss these words in deeply in my next paragraph. So here we will discuss about organelles. How is a cell organized? So class, we saw above that the cell has special components which is called organelles. And now we will study a cell under a microscope. We would come across three features in almost every cell: plasma membrane, nucleus, and cytoplasm, right? We have now studied these three components: plasma membrane, nucleus, and cytoplasm. Class, up to this topic, this page, we have covered three points. Who discovered cell? Robert Hooke, right? How many types of organism we have? Two: unicellular organism and multicellular organism, right? Unicellular organism, I have given you some example: paramecium, right? Amoeba. These are the example of it. Unicellular and multicellular are plants, right? Fungi and animals, right? And now, as I told you, some organelles, some parts of multicellular organisms have different functions which perform different activity in their body, right? So we will discuss now here three cell, every cell, plasma membrane, nucleus and cytoplasm, right class? Let us see how. First, I have here my first topic, plasma membrane. What I have here, my first topic, plasma membrane. As you can see class, plasma, as you can see here, plasma membrane class, this is the outermost covering of the cell that separates the content of the cell from its external environment, and the plasma membrane allow or permit the entry and exit of some material in and out of the cell. So class, the role of plasma membrane is it allow or permit. It means it gives the permission for the entry and exit of some materials in and out of the cell. If something will come inside, that who will give permission? Plasma membrane, right? For the in and out, for both, who will give permission? Plasma membrane. Class, it is also prevent movement of some other materials, and the cell membrane therefore is called a selectively permeable membrane. The second name of plasma membrane is what? Selectively permeable membrane, right? Actually class, I will discuss here one point. Through the shape, size and activities, we have class major functional region of cell, which we are discussing here as a first part, plasma membrane, right? Plasma membrane, also known as cell membrane, as I told you, we can say it is also selectively permeable membrane, right class? So all activities inside the cell and interaction of the cell with its environment is possible due to these features only class, right? Actually, the outer boundary of the cell is called plasma membrane. Just write as a note in your notebook about in between I will tell you where you have to write, okay? Those things you have to note down in your notebook class. So write down about plasma membrane. Only 2 points you have to note down about plasma membrane class. The outer boundary of cell is plasma membrane, and inside it there is cytoplasm, and inside it there is cytoplasm. If I'm repeating two times, then no need to write two times, only you have to write one time class. And various cellular or cell organelles are suspended into cytoplasm. Okay class, now I have here my second paragraph. How does the movement of substances takes place into the cell, and how do substances move out of the cell? Some substances like CO2. Now one question will come in our mind, na? How it will possible for the in and for the out? Who is giving permission? Cell membrane, right? Let's see how. Some substances like CO2 or oxygen can move across the cell membrane by a process called diffusion, right? By diffusion process, right? What can move? CO2 or O2. We have studied the process of diffusion, right? We saw that there is a spontaneous movement of a substance from a region of high concentration to a region where its concentration is low. This is the process of it class. So from high to low concentration level, you can see a substance movement. We can see here something similar to this happen in cells. We can have here like CO2, right? Which glass accumulate in high concentration inside the cell? In a cell external environment, the concentration of CO2 is low as compared to that inside of cell. As soon as there is a difference of concentration of CO2 inside and outside a cell, CO2 moves out of the cell from a region of high concentration to a region of low concentration outside the cell by the process of diffusion. So same process will go with O2. O2 also enter the cell by the process of diffusion. When the level or concentration O2 inside the cell decrease, thus we can say diffusion process plays an important role in gaseous exchange between the cells as well as cell and its external environment class. So we can say water also obey the law of diffusion. The movement of water molecules through such a selectively permeable membrane class is called osmosis, right? So the movement of water across the plasma membrane is also affected by the amount of substance dissolved in water is called what? Osmosis. Thus, osmosis is the passage of water from a region of high water concentration through a selectively permeable membrane to a region of low water concentration till equilibrium is reached. So, this we have discussed today. Now, class, we will discuss next part in our next video. This is we have covered up to page number 4, right? Only 4 points we have covered. Discovery of cell. It is discovered by Robert Hooke in 1665. We have two type of organism, unicellular and multicellular. Unicellular, I have given example. Multicellular, plants, fungi, right? Animals, these are multicellular. And diffusion process I will discuss in my next video in deep so that you can understand in more frequent way. Okay, class, so this is all about my today's video.